Microcasting for your city, Talkapolis.
Bandwidth for today's show is brought to you by SoftLayer.com. We love SoftLayer here at Talkapolis. They are the greatest hosting company ever. They make everything easy. Check out their website at SoftLayer.com. Thanks again for sponsoring the show. Also by Nashville Violins, the string player's number one choice for their string instrument needs. Nashville Violins offers everything from lessons to repairs. Make sure you check them out at NashvilleViolin.com.
Welcome to Music Business Daily, where we bring you the hottest music headlines the most festive ones.
Yes, definitely.
I'm Shara Rivera.
I'm Kelsey Manning.
And we're ready to
rock
and roll
with you. We're joined
by
all of our friends here.
This is Eliza back here.
That's Gertrude.
Oh, okay. I thought that was Geraldine.
Oh, we changed also Geraldine.
Last minute. That's just G.
This is Mitchell.
Hanging on the wall.
And this is Velma. So the whole gang is all here.
We're all welcoming you.
We are. Let's get started.
Let's do. Purple Pain, Foster the People singer kicked out of Prince concert.
Drama.
I just thought this title was so cute.
It is.
So the Foster the People frontman, Mark Foster,
endured
the indirect wrath of Prince last night when he went to a private concert at the Purple One's exclusive LA show at the Sayers Club. And he tried to take his phone out and film the show.
Which
and
is
Prince
not allowed.
Is very anti-internet, basically.
His stuff isn't even on YouTube. He will go in there and take
he hires somebody to, that's his main job, is to make sure none of his stuff got on the internet. Mm. And so, you know, his web sheriff walked right up to Mark Foster and was like, hey, get the F out.
You have to leave. I like that he has a web sheriff. That's one of my favorite things.
I love that.
And also that Mark Foster insisted he was checking a text.
Yeah, of course.
He is an important guy.
He was able to talk his way back in to pay his bar tab and like really apologize. Yeah. I bet they took his phone away too.
Probably.
And they were like, you're
Prince
in trouble.
Prince doesn't have time for that.
No.
No.
He will.
You should be 100% there for When Doves Cry. You don't need to be anywhere else. I don't know why you would be.
Fully
honestly.
Present. Really? Come on.
Honestly,
it's Prince.
It's Prince. Like maybe if you were seeing someone else, I don't know. But Prince, he's a visual artist. And you need to, your eyes need to be there.
He is the artist.
Need to be there. Love this story. Love this story. I think it's great. Paul McCartney came out and said, honestly, guys, Yoko Ono didn't break
Leave
up the Beatles.
Leave her alone, guys.
She didn't break up the Beatles. She didn't.
How many times do I have to say this?
He said, I don't think you can blame her for anything. Basically, he's doing an upcoming TV interview with David Frost. And, you know, I feel like he's been asked this question a lot, you know, and a lot of people get this
question. He's just sick of saying it.
I know. I mean, I feel like people have so much hate towards Yoko Ono, you know, and it just, I mean, the Beatles.
It's unnecessary.
Guys, they were going to fall apart, and that's sad.
And he said, he goes, Lennon was definitely going to leave.
So, I mean, you can't say either way. I just think, you know, there's no bad blood between them, you know, and I think that also, he's just always been so appreciative of her, you know, whether he's putting it on for the cameras, I don't know.
He has been.
He said that Lennon wouldn't have written Imagine without the influence of Yoko Ono, and he said, basically,
she
when you, she
him
came
another
along,
way to be.
Yeah, that he, you know, that Lennon was so taken with her. So, I mean, there's all these different stories about the whole legend of the Beatles. I just think people are never going to get over this anyway. You know, when you have pretty much the biggest band of all time
broken up. I'm sorry John Lennon broke your hearts, y'all.
Yeah.
But you got
to
move on.
You're looking for someone to blame. I'm not moving on yet because...
Somebody else that's moving on, though.
Yes.
Is Blink-182.
Indeed.
They have left Interscope recently.
We reported on that.
Yes, last week with the whole Braveheart issue.
Yeah.
But they're recording a new album in February of this next year.
Dang.
So they are pumped.
I know.
And are they going to be releasing it independently?
I know.
So.
I'm really interested. That came
Me
really fast, too.
Too.
I like that it was kind of good news on the heels of bad news. You know, it was kind of like they were splitting and they had tweeted about it.
I think they were probably waiting. Like, they knew they were going to break up with their label, and that's why they hadn't done anything
lately. But it's nice to hear that right after the other. That they're not, you know, it's like, oh, we're splitting. We don't know what we're going to do. But then it's like they've really said, okay, we're going to record a new album. So I'm interested to
it's
see
happening.
How that's different.
Me, too.
I think they'll still make money, no matter what. No matter what. Bizarre stories. Stories that are just kind of sad. Britney Spears' mom claims that her ex-manager drugged her, like, all the time, which is just, I mean, this whole, you know, they're in this court battle right now between her and her ex-manager and all this stuff.
Yeah, they're saying he crushed up pills and put it in her food all the time.
Yeah.
This was back in the day when she was shaving her head and being crazy.
Yeah.
And she lost her children and all that stuff. And so he told her 5 years ago, I guess, when all this was going on, that he drugged her. And I just... find it very suspicious that, you know, Lynn Spears, why did you wait all this time?
To announce it.
Were that worried, why didn't you go to the police 5 years ago when he was supposedly giving you the drugs?
I don't know. The whole thing is just sad. I mean, I just feel like Britney Spears is just like this American sweetheart that we just learned too much about, and her life just, you know, it's just...
Yeah, I always defend her because I, you know, you don't know what kind of pressure
it's scary to not have a management team that you could trust, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. That's just scary.
But the thing is, for a year, they weren't talking. Spears and her mother weren't even talking, and her manager kept saying, I'm trying to get you two back together. Mm-hmm. So I just, it's bad blood. Britney Spears herself is trying to stay out of it.
You know?
Yeah, but.
It's a scary story about the price of fame.
And it's ruined his reputation a lot.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe he deserved to be ruined. I don't know. We'll see.
We don't know. We'll be following this, kind of, but mainly being sad about it.
Another thing we're following up on that we told you about last week is Ellie Goulding. She split from Skrillex. She was just saying, like, 2 weeks ago that, oh, my God, I love him so much. I want to make an album with him.
We're together forever.
And then she's like, you know what? It's just not working out.
It's not happening. I love that NME, their headline was, we hadn't even decided whether to refer to them as Skrelly or Alex. We didn't have time for that. I kind of like Skrelly. It kind of sounds like Scully.
Oh, so bad.
Halloween jokes. But yeah, so they're not, I mean, they're not together anymore, you know, after 9 months together.
Oh, the price of fame.
So sad, so sad. Well, Christina Aguilera, I can't with this headline, but she just said, I want to play a crackhead on the street.
She wants to take a role outside of herself.
Oh my gosh. She was coming, you know, she was in Burlesque, the movie that didn't do very well. It's kind of like the glitter of her life. Yeah,
not as bad, though.
Not as bad, but so she said she kind of just stumbled into acting, and she wants her next role, she's apparently going to be in a next role, to take her outside of herself. She said she never intended to kick off her acting career with a role so similar to her J job. So not a musical, but that's what she's doing. I mean, that's a normal transition.
That's what she fell into. Right. And it was to work with Cher. Come on.
Obviously.
Who wouldn't take that?
But so, yeah, she said for her next movie, her ideal role, she wants it to be honest and genuine and expanding her wings and doing something really, really different.
Mm-hmm. She wants something crazy, meaty, and juicy.
Which is apparently a crackhead on the street or a drug addict. Apparently that's expanding her wings. She couldn't just play like a high school teacher.
Or a mom.
Or a police officer. No.
It has to be something.
Needs to be a crackhead on the street, apparently. So I don't know if that's a challenging role, but
we'll see.
I don't know. We'll see if that happens. We'll see if it does.
So, speaking of being festive,
yes,
Avril Lavigne's ex dresses up as her for Halloween.
Oh.
Yeah, proving he's really, really, really over her.
Yes.
Him and his best friend dressed up as Avril and her fiancé.
Whatever his name is, Chad Kroeger from
Nickelback. Yeah, the front man. So Nickelback tweeted at them. He said, hey, Derek, love the costumes. We were going to dress up as you guys this year, but all the parties had celebrity themes. Ha ha.
Oh, feuding on Twitter. Guys, really?
I mean, come on, it's your ex.
Yeah. You just need to get over it. Don't dress as your ex. Don't go down.
I'm gonna dress up as you.
Oh, okay.
Because we're best friends.
Well, yes.
I mean, you don't have to dress up as me.
I'm gonna dress up as you.
You could be Hall and Oates.
Yes,
I think you should do that. The halfway with just
Oates.
The mustache on one side and blonde on the other.
You know,
I think it would work for.
Tweet us your Halloween costume ideas.
I was about to say the same thing. You took it right out of my lips.
Well, let's try. Let us know. We should be for
Give
Halloweenopolis. Yes, and have a safe and festive Halloween. If you dress up as something music related and you would like to be featured on Music Business Daily, you know, send us a little email. You know, info@talkapolis.com.
Or emerging artists, if you have a Halloween show.
Yeah.
We want to know.
We want to know all your Halloween
plans. We're still thinking about what to do Halloween night, so we might report on you.
We might.
If you send us a message.
We might, but
we'll see you tomorrow, though.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye.
Microcasting for your city, Talkapolis.